EasyPower 11.0 includes support for single phase and unbalanced three phase power flow calculations. To enable this, under Tools, Options, System, there is a new drop down for power flow calculation method with choices for balanced and unbalanced. Selecting unbalanced will allow for single phase equipment modeled on the one line to be included in power flow calculations and will use the new calculation method for power flow. To edit power flow options, users can either navigate to Tools, Options, Analysis Options within Database Edit, selecting Power Flow, or can simply enter Power Flow and navigate to Power Flow Options. Once in Power Flow Options, the Control tab allows for the behavior of the Power Flow study to be specified. Here, a user can input their desired solution mismatch, limits, motor start solution method, motor start smart breaker behavior, voltage regulator initial condition, and output criteria. Taking a closer look at the output criteria, one can see that overload thresholds as well as voltage thresholds can be specified. In addition, these thresholds can be specified further based on the desired type of comparison. For example, the overload threshold can be set to either positive sequence or phase. Positive sequence uses only positive sequence values to make the comparison, where phase uses the individual phases to compare to one another. Bus undervoltage and overvoltage thresholds can also be specified with these similar options, positive sequence and phase, as well as the addition of the line-to-line option, which uses, as the name suggests, line-to-line quantities to compare to the threshold specified. In addition, there's a bus voltage unbalanced threshold with standard calculation options to compare phases for unbalance. And finally, negative sequence and zero sequence voltage thresholds for comparison. Moving to the text output tab, one will see that this menu allows for a variety of summary reports to be generated, as well as options for generating a detailed report if desired. The standard detail report contains additional information as compared to summary. For example, when the network option is set to elements, the detailed report will show information for all phases A, B, C, and N. The units section is used to designate the units the report will use to display results. There are options for bus voltage and branch flows with a variety of options. The network option dropdown, as previously mentioned, specifies the report format. Positive sequence only will include only results using positive sequence quantities, while symmetrical components will use all three symmetrical component values, positive, negative, and zero sequence. Finally, the elements option reports quantities for each phase, A, B, C, and N. Navigating back to Database Edit View, it could be seen that this system contains three single-phase loads, unbalanced, connected to bus N4. To solve the power flow, simply navigate back to Power Flow and click on Solve. There are one-line display options that can be selected for voltage drop, losses, overloads, voltage violations. In addition, standard options for the one-line display listed above. As well as those one-line display options, users can select from A, B, C, N quantities or positive, negative, and zero sequence quantities. In this case, note that the branch flows and bus voltages being shown for individual phases are unbalanced. Each phase has different quantities displayed, as is expected due to the unbalanced loading present at bus N4. Both bus N3 and N4 have been flagged for voltage violations here based on the various settings specified in the control menu of power flow options that was just shown. Taking a look now at the summary reports that were generated, in this case, only the line overload report was generated, and it's using an overload threshold of 5% based on the maximum phase current. As can be seen, the branch from bus N3 to N4, line 2, is overloaded at 1107 amps. To see that better on the one line, we can switch to overloads, and then we can change our power flow options to display current amps, okay, and see for phase C that 1107 amps was flowing, as was reported, worst case, in the summary report and on the one line for line overloads.